What's up, guys? Caveman Mining here. I hope everyone is well and having a great day. On today's video, we are going to be covering hash rate testing and performance testing on the Quadro RTX 4000 card. For those of you who don't know, this is the world's first ray tracing card ever. And this particular card is not meant for gaming. It is more for workstations, development, rendering, graphic design, and it is a pretty powerful card. It is a blower style card, so you've got the fan here blowing the air out the top. And I believe this video would actually be YouTube's first hash rate testing in terms of this particular card. We're going to look at how well it performs on Ethereum, Ergo, and Raven to start with. And then we'll also do a look at the profitability and the return on investment and the value of this particular card and if it is worth to go out and buy these cards. Without further ado, we will take one of those RTX 4000 cards on the hanging rig and transplant it over down here to the test bench. And we'll jump into Hive and take a look at how things are going. Okay, guys, we have jumped into the laptop. And before we begin, I wanted to take a quick look at the specs and the information on the NVIDIA Quadro RTX 4000 card. And as we get to the specs, you can see the RTX 4000 card has 2,304 CUDA cores. It has 288 Tensor cores, 8 gigabytes of GDDR6 video memory, and we'll look at the max power consumption. So the TDP is 160 watts, so really, really good on the wattage in terms of overall output there. And yeah, just a really sexy, sleek looking card. So this is not what you guys came here to look at, but what we're gonna do is jump into Hive and take a look. We started to mine Ethereum, and I wanted to pull up some information on that for you. As you can see here, we played around with the clocks a little bit, and we got in a locked core clock of 600, the memory clock of 1000, the fan at 100% and power level 100. Now I did play with this with many different locked core clocks, doing the minus 200 or 300 and boosting the memory up to 2000, and nothing really seemed to jive well with this card in terms of that. This is what we really landed on in terms of the efficiency and the highest mega hash output. Let's take a look at this in the Hive shell to see what it's doing live. But I have to say, from an initial standpoint, I am pretty impressed here. I am very impressed. And it's just a well-rounded card. It's pretty good to experiment with this card. Okay, so we are now in Hive Shell. Let's kick off the miner. And we can see here a very, very steady 37.24, 37.23 mega hash, sitting at 79 watts in the software, 477 kilohash per watt, which is the efficiency. So super high in terms of that, right? And it's just really not absorbing that much power, which is great. And you guys can see, if we look to the bottom right-hand corner of the screen at the wall meter, we are pulling between 127 to 129 watts. Very, very steady. Did see one little jump over 130 watts there, but it went down to 126 as well. So very steady, very impressed in terms of what I see. I am very happy with this card. The efficiency is really what takes the cake so far in terms of Ethereum. So I'm pretty impressed there. Let's do a quick what to mine prospect on this card in terms of Ethereum. So we have 37.24 at 126 watts at the wall.
Let's go ahead and calculate that, and it brings us to $2.30. Now, the thing with this card is it's not really a retail card, meaning that unless you find an amazing deal or you know someone that is liquidating these cards or is just simply has no use for these cards, the MSRP is still at $1,000. So if we were to just plug that in, it would be on 12 cents electric rate based off of this power and based off of this hash rate, that would be 439 days to get your return on investment. So I wouldn't recommend that. I mentioned I wouldn't tell you what I got these cards for, but I actually got them for $450 a piece, which is not bad. So that brings, if you were to get it for what I purchased them for, be about 198 days return on investment with Ethereum. So not too bad. Like I said, pretty rare cards in terms of being able to find them for a cheap price. But if you do, or if you can buy them used or whatnot, not too shabby there. Not too shabby at all. But let's switch gears. I'm gonna do a little edit here, and I'm going to switch us over to Ravencoin, and we'll see what that pulls in terms of hash rate and efficiency. So just be with you in 1 second. Okay, guys, so we are back in Hive OS, and we've got Ravencoin kicked off. Let's take a look at the clocks really quick. We've got 200 on the core, 2,200 on the mem, power level set to default zero, letting the software in the card handle its own power limit at 125 watts in the software. We see that we have 19.09 for MegaHash to start here. Let's go ahead and turn on Hive Shell and see what we can see within the software. And if we look over to the wall meter, we can see that we're pulling between 181 and 185, 186. Yeah, between 180 and 186 seems to be the at-the-wall hardware power limit in terms of wattage. So let's take a look in the miner and see what we have here. Yeah, 1907, 1908 in terms of hash rate, and 66 degrees Celsius, 124 watts in the software, and 154 kilohash per watt in terms of efficiency. So not too crazy or too bad there. I was expecting probably a little bit lower hash rate, so you know, in my mind, this has already exceeded my expectations already in terms of hash rate and efficiency. So not bad at all. Let's go ahead and take a look at the what to mine, and let's go ahead and key in some Ravencoin prospects here. So let's go ahead and put in 1909, and we said 180 watts at the wall. Let's go ahead and key that in. And we've got $1.49 on Ravencoin, if I am not mistaken. So definitely better to mine Ethereum if you can on these cards, but still, $1.49 is $1.49 a day. It's profitable if you believe in the Ravencoin project and coin and long-term value. Why not? So pretty cool test results. I haven't really messed around too much with Ravencoin on this, but that's good. And the last but not least, we will do a quick cut here and we will switch over to Ergo, and we will have our final wrap up and conclusion. Okay, and last but not least, we are now mining Ergo, and let's go ahead and take a look at the clocks that we are using. And we did minus 200 on the core, 2400 on the memory, 100% on the fan, and 110 on the power limit. We could not get this card to play nice with the locked core clock, and just wattage seemed to be a little bit all over the place. We could try it again here. We will test that in just a second, but you can see we're getting hash rates between 70 to 7250 to 7223. Let's go ahead and try the locked core clock again. You can see Let's take a look at the wall meter. If we look at the bottom right-hand corner of the screen, we're pulling about 162 to 164, 166 watts. So yeah, averaging probably about 164 watts at the wall. So a little bit higher in terms of wattage at the wall this go around. But let's, for the sake of testing, go ahead and try the same clock output as we did with Ethereum to get that core clock locked in. And let's see if we can get a little bit better at the wall wattage, because that is the key, if we can really dip down. Okay, so this looks promising. You get about 120 to 127 watts at the wall. Let's see if we get a dip in hash rate majorly at this point, because we've changed things up here. But yeah, 7209 is the first hash rate that we have pulled, and just waiting for the second one to register. If it goes higher or lower, then we'll have a better idea. And yeah, take a look at that, we're dipping down. Let's see if we can leave the core as is and go back up on the memory and see if that does anything. We're gonna try to experiment with this live. I did not really play too much with these clocks beforehand. Let's boost the memory up to 2300 and see if we can get back into the 70 range to 72. That would be great if we can do that, plus by means of staying at low wattage at the wall, because we're dipping now under 120 watts at 119. Let's see if we can creep back up into the 70s, because I would be pretty happy with that if we were able to do 70 mega hash on Ergo at 119 watts at the wall. That wouldn't be too bad at all. Let's take a look here. It's like the drum roll, just eagerly, anxiously awaiting this next hash rate. And hey, look at that. So coming back up here. So yeah, we needed to lock that core clock in. We needed to go up higher on the memory. I'm assuming because of the jump in hash rate, we'll probably go a little bit higher than this if we can get back into the 72, 73 range. I would be quite happy with that for Ergo. And still holding steady at 119 at the wall. And yeah, dipping back down to 69, 70. So we'll just say 70 mega hash at 119 at the wall for Auto Lycos, so 70 and 119. Let's go ahead and key that in. And we have $1.12. So we did pretty good there. We had $2.30 on Ethereum, $1.50 on Ravencoin, and $1.12 on Ergo. So hey, it is a card, and if it's available and it's cheap, definitely use it. I was fortunate enough to get these at a low price from a friend, so I probably would steer clear of buying these at scalped or MSRP price. Even with Ethereum, that 400 days plus is not looking like a healthy return on investment. But we wanted to test this out, and I got some questions when I showcased my rig in the past to, show you guys the performance and hash rates on these different algorithms, and there you have it. So I hope you enjoyed the test today. And if you'd like to see more or different algorithms, if you'd like to see me test something else, please let me know in the comments below. And if you liked what you saw, hit that thumbs up and subscribe to keep us flowing and going. And we will see you guys on the next video. Everyone take care. Bye-bye.